Ulta Beauty is coming under fire after the company sent out an email to its mailing list with what is being called an insensitive choice of words. It had to do with the Kate Spade promotion for her line of perfumes, that company's lines of perfumes, and it was titled Come Hang with Kate Spade. Kate Spade, the person behind the brand, hung herself in 2018, and you have to wonder how something like this happens. The brand, Ulta, has apologized for this, but was it someone who wasn't familiar with the history? Was it someone trying to make a very terrible, macabre joke? It's unclear where the quality control was in the situation.
I think a simple Google search ahead of sending out a marketing campaign like this would have helped. But, and then secondarily, I don't think this would have happened under former CEO Mary Dillon. I think she had a great, tremendous control of her organization, a phenomenal leader. She's no longer leading the company as CEO. Just don't think what happened under her leadership.
I mean, this is why you have levels of approvals that take place for any type of correspondence, communication, whether they be internal or external. And, I mean, the company squarely just has to look across its own kind of internal assets that they have, human resources, and then all the way down to where those different checkpoints, as a former marketer, you've got people that are weaved into even the processes that these communications are being crafted within. And so everybody has the ability to see it before it goes out, whether internal or external.
Yeah, so who knows what happened there. Meanwhile, as we're looking at the cosmetic space, I have to mention Estee Lauder today, and that's because their stock is down some 5% after the company came out and cut its earnings forecast, and in part blamed what's going on globally here, supply chain disruptions in China, what's happening in Europe in terms of consumer spending there because of the Russian invasion of Ukraine. So pointing a lot of fingers at different areas here.
Yeah, not the first company to warn about conditions in China given those lockdowns. Of course, we heard something similar from Apple when it reported last week. But clearly, this is something impacting Estee Lauder. Might impact Ulta a little less because, of course, they're not in China. But also, too, I would keep in mind Starbucks, I believe, reports after the close today. You would think their China business is going to be weak because of a lot of the factors that Estee Lauder brought up as well.
Right. Well, there's two things here. There's selling in China and there's making in China. And a lot more companies are affected by that. All right. Got to leave it there. Yeah.